Passing chords in the key of G. This is important for you to learn if you're playing in the key of G. Now, this lesson is an extract of our full G course. We have a full course in the key of G called the G Intermediate course that goes for over 2 hours. So this is just a brief extract of one of the chapters in that course. But if you want to learn key G in detail, this concept plus much more, kindly check the description below this video. You'll find a link to our website and our contacts. But for now, let's enjoy this to the end. Okay, so in this section, you're going to do something very exciting. What I love, and these are called the passing chords. Okay, of course, we are in the key of G. Now, these are just movements which help you to move from one chord to another. Passing movements, meaning that they may not be part of the song, but they are movements which help you to fill in gaps and to transition from one chord to another. Okay, so let me start just by saying that on a scale, as we said before, we have 8 positions. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. For example, on G major scale. Now we can have passing chords as we move from one chord to another. Okay, and there are different kinds of types of chords we can use, but some of the best that I like using most of the time are dominant seventh chords and diminished seventh chords. Okay, those two types of chords are really what I would like to highlight in this section. Okay, how we use those two types of chords as passing chords. If you've done any of my other courses, you realize that the concept is still the same. And that's what you need to realize, that in every key, the concept you apply in one key when you're finding passing chords, you just translate the same thing in the other key. The concept remains the same. Okay, so for example, I'm here in position 1. I'm playing my G major chord. Okay, now I want to move from 1 to 2. Right, so I want to move from G major to A minor. Remember, chord number 1 is G major. Chord number 2 is A minor. So now what I usually do is I think of it, okay, my destination is A. I can arrive at A using two positions, from the front or from the back, okay? So I'm going to A minor. I can approach this A minor from the A sharp or from the G sharp. There are two ways. Now, that is the case where I want to use a diminished seventh chord. So when I'm moving from G major and the next chord is a 2, which is A minor, I can use this A sharp diminished seventh chord, which is A sharp, C sharp, E, and G. Or I can use a G sharp diminished seventh chord, which is G sharp, B, D, and F. So these are two options I can use: A sharp diminished seventh chord or G sharp diminished seventh chord as a passing chord to A minor or A minor seventh if you add the G, okay? A minor, A, C, E, add the G, get A minor seventh in whatever inversion that you are in. A minor, add the G, A minor seventh. So what we mean is this: moving from G and then I pass through this G sharp diminished to my A minor seventh, or I can start with my G, then A sharp to A minor. Now, what you realize is that you can always invert these chords. Now, when you invert diminished seventh chords, the name of the chord may change. For example, I'm trying to avoid to do this kind of movement. For example, from G all the way here, okay, to the G sharp diminished seventh chord. What I can do, I can bring this F here, okay, so that I have this chord. Now, it is a G sharp diminished seventh, but when I invert it, okay, when I bring the F here, the name of this chord can change. It's now like F diminished seventh, okay? F, G sharp, B, and D, right? So you can think of it as G sharp diminished seventh or F diminished seventh. So I'll maintain the root on the left, okay, to the G sharp. So I'm playing a slash chord here, F diminished seventh and G sharp. See that common note? So and then to my two now, A minor seven. Now there's this song I love, a worship song, How Excellent Is Your Name, O Lord. I know I'll do an example, but I would like to mention this here because of just the section of the song I want to mention, okay? How excellent is your name, O Lord. So the progression is one, and then this passing chord, which is the flat two, because the two is A, the G sharp is a flat two. How excellent is your name, O Lord. Then you play the five, and in this case I'm playing just the D dominant seventh chord. D, F sharp and A is D major. When you add the C, you get D dominant seventh chord. Okay? So it's one, flat two, which is our passing chord, and then two, five, one. Back to G major. How excellent is your name, O Lord. Just an example of how you can apply that passing chord. Now, the other passing chord we said you can apply, remember we have been using that G sharp diminished seventh, but we just inverted it. We brought the F down here. We can use the A sharp diminished seventh. The same thing. You can bring the G here. So, in a sense, you are using a G diminished seventh chord. Okay? Which is the same as A sharp diminished seventh. So, you can also use this diminished seventh chord as your passing chord to the A minor. Okay? So. How excellent. Okay, we have to use the A sharp. How excellent. Trying to keep this simple because this course is meant for intermediate, beginner to intermediate level, okay? So that's an example of how we approach a position of a chord using diminished seventh chord as a passing chord. Remember, just to mention again, if I'm moving from one to two, my destination is two, I can approach these two using G sharp or A sharp, back or front. And you can use these chords as diminished seventh chords, okay? A final example on this diminished seventh application. For example, if I'm moving from 4 to 5. What is 4 to 5? Of course, 4 is C, 5 is D. I'm moving from C major to D major. I'm looking for passing chords in these positions, okay? My destination is what? 5. So I can approach this 5 from two angles, from the C sharp or from the D sharp. Just make this a C sharp diminished seventh chord, which is C sharp, E, G, and A sharp, or D sharp diminished seventh chord, which is D sharp, F sharp, A, and C. So we can approach this chord using that or that. So, or now remember we can invert these chords, instead of playing that C sharp there, we can bring that A sharp here. So in other words, we have an A sharp diminished seventh chord, okay? So sounds better, okay? because the notes are coming in a little bit closer. Instead of having that there, it's better to have it down here. So instead of that, we are playing this. So. Or remember, we can play the D sharp diminished seventh chord, okay? So we can bring the C here. Okay? So it's like a C diminished seventh chord. And then we play with the D sharp. Remember, you can invert it again. Instead of using this, you can bring the A again back. So you have like kind of now an A diminished seventh chord. Okay. So A, C, D sharp, F sharp. So. Okay. Now, an exercise that you can do with these diminished seventh chords. Now, for example, we can use dominant seventh chords now. Let's first leave the diminished seventh chord at that place. Let me talk about the dominant seventh chords as passing chords. What you need to do is this. Look at your destination and ask yourself, what is the five of your destination chord? What is the five in the scale of that key? For example, yes, you are playing in key G and you want to move to A minor from G major to A minor. Okay, now ask ourselves, what is the five of A in the scale of A? Now in this case, you need to know all the major scales. So what is the five of A in the A major scale? A, B, C sharp, D, E, F sharp, G sharp, A. I encourage students that even if you can't play in every key, at least know all the major scales. They'll help you a lot in constructing chords and passing chords. Okay, so the five of key A is E. So...